What is going on? It is windy, it is cold, but I am going to do some pike fishing. Tip-ups is the plan. Actually, I fish pros, something a little bit different than tip-up. I'm gonna fight them on a rod and a reel. But yeah, we'll talk about more of that in a little bit. I'm gonna try to develop some kind of game plan here. I've got, you can see a little, maybe a rock spine. I don't know if you can see that or not in the background. I got a rock spine kind of coming off the shore here. I'm gonna drill some holes in this area. I've never fished this spot before. So I'm taking a stab in the dark. Oh yeah, this won't last forever, right? Look at this. Fancy new auger. Woo, woo! 7 feet. 7 feet, that's good. I'll drill one hole this way yet, and one hole this way, and see if it's kind of just really flat here, or to see if there's like a drop off here. I'll probably drill out a little bit and try to find a little bit of a drop off here as well. So a little bit of a drop off here. Let's see how far I gotta go out to get like to say 10 feet-ish. I like this depth though, this is good. It's a good depth for them slough sharks. 7.7 and 10 feet. I got 10, this is perfect. Okay, let's see there. The wind is calming down a little bit. It's supposed to calm down a little bit more throughout the day, which is good news. Fog's lifting, got some blue skies in the horizon. But yeah, I got a couple holes drilled here. I'm gonna get the big camera set up, get a bait down, soaking. First thing you do when you're pike fishing, get some bait in the water as quick as you can. Get fishing as fast as possible and figure things out. Tip of the day, fish. When you go fishing, the tip is to fish. I'm gonna run this one at about 3.5 feet up. Don't think you always have to run your baits right near the bottom. Pike do have eyes on the top of their head and they look up a lot. In 7 feet of water, if you run the tip up literally just below the ice, you'll do fine. You'll do really good actually. But really make sure when your flag pops that the line is on the other side of the flag. If the wind's going this way, have the bow on your line this way. So the flag comes up, it hopefully doesn't catch the line. If you got it set the other way, the line would then bow into the flag. You'd be very, very careful of that. I'll talk more about these iFish pros as I go, but I got the first one down here. It's at 4 feet below the surface and I'm in 7 feet deep. So I'm kind of right in the middle of the water column. Okay, the dirty work's done. I got out a couple tip ups. Starting to get a little bit nicer out. I'm going to get into a hoodie as well and kick back, get some underwater cameras going here. Yeah, just kind of dial everything in now that I got my two baits out. Like I said earlier, get your baits out, then you can start fine tuning from there. This flag went off as I was changing my battery on my camera. Fortunately, I should have it on the underwater camera though. I'm gonna let it run here. I'm gonna close the bail. Holy, he is just peeling. He's peeling so fast. My bait runner's on. I'm gonna tighten my drag and then I'm gonna slam him here right away. Come on. I think he's just coming at me. He's just coming at me. Yeah, I got him. Wow, that was insane. That thing peeled so much line. Like, I've just got everything set up. I've got my under, it's coming right at me. It's coming at me. I don't know where my drag's at. My drag's good. Maddie's coming straight at me. That fish hit and it's peeling. Oh, man, that camera just shut off for some reason. I don't know what. There he goes. That was insane. Like, I heard the flag just pop. Where is he? He's coming at me. I still got him. He's still there. Come on, where are you? Where are you? Oh, he's got some weight to him. He's got some weight to him. All of a sudden it got easier, but it's just because he was swimming at me. OK, Okay, like I was saying, I gotta regroup here for a minute and focus on what I wanna say. I was changing my battery on my main camera and I turned around, I was getting the battery out of my truck and all of a sudden I heard the flag pop. So I never saw it. Don't have the flag popping on camera, but I should have the EAT on the underwater camera, which is right beside me. I don't know if you can see it. Man, this fish has some weight to him. And when he hit it, he just started peeling, like he dumped this spool. Wow, it's got some good weight. I've got a live well right behind me. Look at that. Nice. It's got some weight. I've got a live well right behind me. I don't have any tools here with me, so I'm gonna pull this fish out. I'm gonna put him right in the live well, bring the camera over there, talk a little bit about it, work on the fish in there. These longer rods here are really nice for fighting big pike. Jeez, he's got some weight. Where are you, buddy? Where are you? It's kind of hooked on the edge of the hole too. I gotta get my rod down there a bit. I don't know why it's hooked on the edge of the hole. I've got to get my scoop and knock that line off the edge of the hole. Okay, there, popped it off. There we go. That's good. The line grooved itself into the bottom of the ice, and my slip knot there. My bobber stopper was stuck in that groove in the ice. See, my bobber stopper's up here now. Oh, that's a big fish. That's a big fish. Oh, it's a big pike. Oh, come on. I was on my camera, of course. That's always fun. The camera's short. I can pull that up quick if I need to. I have got just a ruckus going on here. I don't even know how well this looks on camera, but he is a big pike. Jeez. I'm gonna have to pull my camera up. Look at that. Stuck everywhere. Oh, I'm glad I'm using some heavier braided line right now, because I've got a mess going on. Okay, I'm free. Get my drag tightened. Okay, now I've had a gong show with this fish, but it is a big pike. Oh yeah. Oh, it's a really nice fish. Oh baby. Oh baby. Oh, careful. Don't you dare try to take my hand off, buddy. Oh, come back up the hole. I got one hook in the mouth and one hook up on the side. So if I get it started again, I should be able to get her. It's a big pike. Come on. Hockey stick. Come on, Crosby. There she comes. There. Oh, big mouth. Big mouth. Easy, girl. Easy, girl. Can't feel my hands. Oh, that's big pike. Look at that thing. Yes. Oh, look at, see? That's why I couldn't get her turned up the hole right there, the hook on the bottom. Oh, baby. That's big. I'm going to get her in the live well quick, though, and get her all sorted out. It's heavy. That's a heavy fish. Oh, baby. That's a heavy fish. Okay. There it sits. Fish right there in the live well. She is looking good. So that was a big confusion. Got sunglasses on now because the sun just kind of peeked out and my eyes are really sensitive to light. But I got this fish chilling live, like I said. I'm going to put her on the bump board quick and then I'm going to release her kind of all in one shot, not mess around with her a little bit. I got her in the live well. I got the hooks out. She's sitting upright. She's healthy. She's kicking around, which is good. She had a little bit of blood, but she's stopped bleeding now. It's a nice thing with the cold water. It really coagulates their holes, their blood that they get. And I saw when she was first in there, she was kind of spurting out a little bit of blood, but now I've kept an eye on her and she's actually stopped bleeding. So that's a-okay. So yeah, I'll pull her out, measure, not gonna weigh her. She had enough trauma in her life today. Measure, get her back in. How's that for light? That's probably really, really bad right into the sun, hey? Yeah, I'll learn one day. So yeah, let's get her done. She is a toad.
Yes! Oh, unbelievable first fish. Let's get her on the bump board real quick and see what she weighs. Not weighs, what she measures. She's heavy. Like, my hands are shaking. She's got some good girth to her. Okay, girl. What is the tail of the tape going to say? Oh, she just clips 40 inches. 4-0. Nice. Big mama. Unbelievable. That was a gong show. I'm going to get her back though and get some more pike today. Like this, I hope. My hands are shaking. Okay, that's enough for you. Oh, that's a nice fish. Oh, okay. Oh, unbelievable. Oh, okay. Get their tail nice and low in the water so they're able to kick away. If you hold them too high up and they start to kick, their tail's what pushes the water. They can't get any momentum. You got to get them nice and low so when they kick, they can take off. But yeah, that was intense. Complete gong show. Like I said, I was switching the battery. Flag went off. Should have it all captured on the underwater camera though, the eat. So that's exciting. There was a gong show at the hole landing the fish because it was kind of hooked down here, and I had to get a scoop, and then I had to get a hockey stick, and eventually I got it all and I got her up, but it was a little bit of a gong show. But the live well here, which I'm going to talk about, I think today, I talked about in a video 2 years ago, but I'm going to cover it again today. So my first pike of 2019, 4-0, 40 inches, baby. Yes. Okay. I ignore the drone noise. I'm gonna show you quickly how I make one of these live wells, and then I'll explain why. First step though, to drill about 5 or 6 connecting holes here. That's with a 10 inch auger. With say an 8 inch auger, you're probably gonna make 6 to 7 connecting holes. Important, don't go all the way through. Go about 3/4 of the way through or halfway through the ice, something like that, but don't go all the way through. I'm kicking the snow away as soon as I finish that first hole so I can see kind of where to start that hole, that next one. You want to get, you know, kind of about 3/4 of the way over. All of this snow and slush is going to have to come out one way or another, so it's best just to kind of take it all out right now. So now if you want, you can take your auger, and electric augers work great for this, and kind of just chip away at some of the sharper edges. And now what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna drill a hole right through that's not connected to the live well. But what this will do is when the hole drills through, I can plunge some of the water up and it's gonna fill this live well up completely. Clear out the rest of the slush now. Finished product. I'm gonna get the drone away or bring it down so it's not so noisy. I'm gonna talk about this live well just a little bit of when to use it, when not to use it, and what to do at the end of the day after you're done fishing. So what do we use this live well for? Well, super simple, actually, to take care of the fish, to take better care of the fish, or at least, you know, treat it as best as we can, especially when it's a little bit colder out and it's windy and its eyes are gonna freeze if you have the fish out of the water too long. So as you saw, that fish was chilling in that live well there, and I went up to it and I pulled it up and I showed it to the camera and I did a measurement and I sent it back down. Now you can put that fish in there if you have a couple buddies, you can do a photo really quick with it there and then release it, type of thing. Same idea, just to take good care of that fish. I always like to tell people basically that if you fight a fish for a super long time and you pull it out of the water, it's struggling to breathe a little bit. Compare it to if you were gonna do a marathon, right? And right after that marathon, you're super, super tired and somebody put your head and they dunked it in the water, right? How much harder would that be to catch your breath? You're not gonna be able to hold your breath as long as you can under that water, right? Because you're super, super tired, you're exhausted. Same type of thing for a fish. The fish gets their oxygen from the water, so as soon as you pull them out, they're gasping for breath, right? So they've just had a long exhausted battle. They're, you know, their lungs are pumping that much harder. So if you can get them in a live well right after the fight, just let them chill you're good to go. If you're just gonna release the fish right away, no problem. But if you pull that fish out and you plan on taking some photos with it, you're better off just to kind of let it chill in the live well for a bit. Yes, it's gonna be a little bit more lively on you when you go to take the photos after, but that fish has had time to catch its breath again in the water. It's got its oxygen pumping again. And now when you pull it out and it has to hold its breath for a little bit out of the water, because obviously fish breathe that oxygen in the water, it's easier for them. Just think of it next time you do a, if you run around a little bit, whatever it is, and you're breathing heavy, stick your head in water and see how much harder it is for you to catch your breath. You'll be able to hold your breath a lot longer if you're relaxed, you know, and you're ready to go and you're not tired, and you stick your head down in the water, you'll be able to hold your breath longer. So with the live wells, I'm going on about this for a long time already, with the live wells not for keeping fish in all day, getting hero doubleheader photos with it. I saw a photo a couple years ago with like all these guys with like these giant walleyes. So they kept all these walleyes in the live well all day and stressed them out. This is temporary, right? In and back out. It's just proper fish management and that's it. Keep in mind too that it's a closed area. So the fish is in there, he's going to use up all that oxygen in the water. So if you put a fish in there and release them, you know, don't forget to plunge your hole beside it a little bit after, get some fresh water in there again, get that oxygen kind of back up to proper levels. If you put a bunch of fish in there to keep, you know, that's your plan for the end of the day, you're going to keep them alive for the day, and then you're going to kill them the end of the day and clean them. Perfect. But remember, if you go to put a bigger fish in there by the end of the day, those smaller fish have been using up all that oxygen in that live well. It's a great tool to use. At the end of the day, make sure you mark it really well, because it is easy to drop a tire in there from a truck. That's why we do a live well. Don't abuse it, but definitely use it for sure. Well, a little bit of a lunch break time here while I wait for more pike to come by. I'm having a Aaron Weeb special today here. He taught me how to make homemade chicken noodle soup on the ice. Like I said, homemade. Homemade chicken noodle soup right here. Homemade. Thanks, Aaron. That's all I'm doing right now. Boiling some water there. You saw me use that little cooker there earlier in the season when I did a catch and cook for walleye. If you haven't watched that video, come on, go now. It's a good video, kinda. Water's boiling, so in goes the soup. Or just starting to boil. And if you forget all your utensils, you got no spoon, jaw spreaders. That's how you stir your soup. Mmm, this is gonna hit the spot today. Okay, soup is fini. I'm gonna dump it into this bowl here. Let it cool off a bit. And then we have chicken noodle soup. Oh, flag, I had one false flag right here, and my other flag just went up over there. I gotta get over there. This one is set. Just, I had that flag go off, didn't connect, and then all of a sudden this one, this is a little bit smaller bait than that one over there, so better chance this one stays hooked up. I'm gonna peel some line out here. It's running with it. I wanna hit it right away. Okay, there we go. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, what is going on? It feels so weird. I got it. It feels like it's rubbing. Oh, I guess it could have been rubbing against the camera. That was so weird. Just mayhem. That one goes off. I don't know if I didn't let it take it long enough, and all of a sudden it's gone. And I look over, well, I didn't look over, I heard the noise actually. This one went off. Not a monster. Oh, not bad though. Not a bad fish. Oh girl, whoa girl, whoa girl. Whoa, girl. Watch that top hook is swinging like crazy. Here we go. Okay. Come on, girl. Okay, hook's out. There we go. Good looking fish. I want to get her back as quick as I can, though, because it is windy and cold outside. She's bleeding a little bit. So let's get her back. Kicked off. Here she goes.
Awesome.
Okay, that's gonna wrap up my day today. The wind is picking up like crazy. It's temperatures dropping extreme. I don't wanna put any more pressure on these fish in terms of bringing them out in the elements. Just not good for them right now. If I had more daylight right now, I'd throw up the shelter and fish out of that, but I just don't want to mess around with Mother Nature and the fish. Got a storm moving in, so I'm gonna get off the body of water here. Smart thing to do, right? Always be safe. I'm gonna do something a little bit different here. There's a bunch of things I didn't cover today. Rods, reels, bait. I never explained how I use the iFish Pro. Here's what I'm gonna do. In 3 days from now, I'm gonna post a follow-up video to this. It's gonna be done in my little workshop, my garage, and I'm gonna explain everything that I use today. So if you have any questions from today's video, leave it in the comments below and I'll cover that in there. I'm gonna try something a little bit different. I don't know if I'm gonna continue this for all my videos, but 3 days from now, there'll be another video. 3 days from now, there'll be another video about today, a little bit of a follow-up. So leave your comments below right here and I will try to get back to most of the questions, or at least the most asked questions. Like I said, I'll go through the rods, the reels, the iFish Pros. I'll go through the gear that I use today to help you go out and kind of duplicate what I just did. The pike fishing right now, today, a little bit slower, four flags, two fish landed, but it's just gonna ramp up as the season progresses. The 40 inch I caught today has some good chunk to her, so I'm kind of excited what's to come for the spring. Big winter coming yet. Thanks for watching, and as always, we'll see you soon.